हाय गाइस, वेलकम टू श्री साई शॉर्ट हैंड कोचिंग सेंटर। 120 वर्ड्स पर मिनट डिक्टेशन, 5 मिनट्स ड्यूरेशन। गेट रेडी, स्टार्ट। मिस्टर प्रेसिडेंट, आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक यू होल हार्टेडली फॉर होस्टिंग दिस हिस्टोरिक कॉन्फ्रेंस एम्ड एट प्रोटेक्टिंग अवर एनवायरनमेंट सो एज टू प्रिजर्व अवर प्लैनेट for the future generations to come. The city in which you are hosting the conference is quite serene and at the same time abounds in vitality. In other words, it reflects the benediction of nature on the one hand and the human urge to enhance its splendor on the other. We cherish the warmth of the welcome that we have received from the government and the people of this great country. Though we belong to different countries, I would like you to remember the fundamental fact that we inhabit a single planet. We belong to different races and different religions, but we are all primarily human beings. It is quite unfortunate that while one part of this planet rejoices in plenty, the other part suffers from want. The plenty in the first part has brought pollution to its people, and the want has degraded the lives of people in the other part. I hope you will agree with me that such a fragmented planet can assure neither peace nor development to the people dwelling on it. It is therefore the responsibility of all the countries of the world to ensure that the affluence of some nations is not derived from the poverty of many others. I urge upon those who are attending this historic conference to contribute their mite to strike a golden mean between drawing what we need from the nature for our day-to-day existence and leaving to it what it requires to sustain itself for the future generations to come. As it is, as several countries share this planet, it is true that very little can be done by a single country. But collectively, if we put together all our efforts, there is no reason why we cannot do something worthwhile to sustain life on this earth for centuries to come. It is a matter of great satisfaction that there is a large-scale awareness among the people of all the countries, both developed and developing, about the need to protect the environment. I desire that this consciousness should cross the political boundaries and should become a common national and international norm. We in our country are engaged from the very beginning in finding some practical measures to this pressing problem. My predecessor, having thought over the subject of environment minutely, had suggested the creation of a planet protection fund for the purpose of developing technologies in order to help protect the environment. I appeal to the leaders of all the countries to give a serious thought to this proposal, as it is absolutely necessary to develop a whole range of such technologies. I would like to make myself quite clear at this juncture. It is not a simple question of transfer of technology. In fact, we have to make a beginning by stopping the transfer of such technologies which are intended for the destruction of the environment. Only then we can achieve something tangible. In this collective endeavor, there is an equally important responsibility on the part of the industrially developing nations. The people of those countries are really fortunate that they have developed a close affinity with nature and have not become experts in creating pollution, and at the same time becoming victims of it. In this process, they might have quite naturally learned to make use of the natural resources to the maximum extent possible. The people from the developed countries have to learn from the lives of these people the element of contentment which is preventing over exploitation of natural resources.